हेलो एवरीवन, गुड इवनिंग। हाँ, सम पीपल आर जॉइनिंग। जस्ट ए सेकेंड, आई एम वेटिंग फॉर 2-3 मिनट्स। जस्ट वेट गाइस। या गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। आई गॉट रिस्पॉन्स, लॉट्स ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सेस। मानसी, आयुष, आशीष, कपिल, उज्ज्वल, चयन, स्वाति, स्वानी, रजनीश, अक्षय, भूपेंद्र, कृष्णा, दानियाल एंड गणेश, एंड देर आर सम अदर ऑल्सो। I got a question from Bhupinder from where to upload file in Jupyter. I'll just tell you, wait a minute. Pushpendra is asking which are the other programming languages we can use in ML. You can also use MATLAB, as well as some people are also using the Java also. Okay. Okay, now I'm going to start the next topic. That is, today we will be implementing supervised linear machine learning model. Okay, so you can open this link, and here you can see we have solved a problem, Boston housing price prediction. You know the problem is this, like predicting the prices of houses in the Boston. We have a data set of a particular city of Boston, and in that we have data in which we have features of houses, and we need to predict the price of houses. Basically, we want to predict some numerical value. That's why we are going to use here regression. Okay. I got a question. Which one is best? Pushpendra is asking. Which one language is best for the ML? Pushpendra, I think most of the people nowadays are using the Python. So Python is more like it is a good choice. Okay. So just you need to implement this with me so that you will get all these things. Okay, guys. So first thing, you should know that what is the actual problem we have. We have some data set in which you can imagine in your own colony, like in your colony, you have data set of all the houses, like house, particular house area, and then the crime rate of that particular colony, distance from the famous places, more reachable to the public, and all these parameters we have for a particular a colony houses, and we need to predict the price of that houses. We in the data set we have also price, but in the future if you want to predict price for a particular house, then you can do using this algorithm. So basically we are going to predict a numerical value here, right? So what are the libraries we need for this? Simply we need the one library is we need pandas, and another one we need the numpy and matplotlib. These are the basic library that you already know. We need to import these libraries. Okay, so importing some important data science libraries and data set to make linear regression model for house price prediction. Okay, we simply we are going to predict the price of a particular house. Daniel is asking, ma'am, where to download the Boston data set? I'm telling you, just read, Daniel. You do not need to download any file. I'll just tell you. Okay, you just open your editor in which you are working, and you can just follow the steps like as I'm telling you, so that you will implement during the class only. Because one implementation is important. After that, you can work over by yourself also. Okay. So just follow the steps. Simple libraries, and there is the another library called the sklearn. Have you heard about the sklearn? Some of you I already know the about the sklearn. Sklearn is a library which have different things. Like I can search over the Google. I'm going to Google and typing sklearn in Python. Simple. Okay. Here you can see this is the official website of sklearn. Okay, I'm clicking here and it will open a site. Yes, I'll explain over the Jupyter. Don't worry, I'm just starting. I'll explain over the Jupyter. I'm opening a new Python. Okay, I'll write a code here also. Just I'm explaining initially what is the sklearn. Basically, sklearn is a library that have different things. This library is mainly built for the machine learning in the Python. It have different algorithms, it have different data sets, and it have different parameters to measure an algorithm like performance, accuracy, all these things this have. Okay? Gaurav, you are lit. Hans, Gun is also lit. Guys, just connect at 5:30. It's only 1.5 hour class. Okay. So what I'm going to do here, I was just telling you what is the sklearn library. Basically, sklearn library is a library for the machine learning. It have machine learning algorithms, it have certain data sets, and it have certain model evaluation functions. Okay, so in the official guide of the sklearn, you can read the different things. The purpose of this guide to illustrate some of the main features that sklearn provides. It assumes a very basic working knowledge of machine learning practice, model fitting, predicting, and cross-validation. Please refer to our installation instruction for installing sklearn. We do not need to install the sklearn in Jupyter. It already have. You can try it like this, import sklearn if it is creating any problem, then you can install it like write pip install sklearn. No, right now we are using the sklearn. This is the more powerful library. There are other libraries also available, but we are using this one. Upendra is telling me, ma'am, voice is breaking. Can you guys please confirm me, my voice is clear or not? And it is actually breaking. Just tell me. Not clear. I think my fan is on. So I'll clear it. Just wait. Hello guys. Now it is clear. Okay, it was voice of my fan. Okay, thank you so much. So I was telling you about the sklearn. Sklearn is a library for the machine learning basically. It has some data sets also, it has some algorithms also, and it has some model evaluation functions also. Okay, so like what we are going to do here, we are just going to import some important libraries. Like, I'm just importing all these. Just I'm importing pandas, matplotlib, numpy, and the different algorithm here is, you already know matplot, numpy, pandas, and now the new thing is sklearn. I'm importing the sklearn, and in the sklearn we have different algorithms that we have inside the sklearn linear model. Okay, there is a package inside the sklearn. We have a package called the linear model, and we have package called the data sets, and we have called package matrices, like linear models in the Python. You can see here documentation. Okay, so this one is the simple linear model. We have linear regression, this, and here you can read the documentation if you want. Each and everything is clearly described. Okay guys, Python is open source and there are everything available. You can check over the internet. So like we can understand each and everything from the internet using this if we have basic knowledge of things. Okay, so first thing is, I have just imported sklearn and dot linear model sklearn, and from sklearn linear model I have imported the linear regression. Okay, सिंपली मैंने क्या किया है, sklearn से, sklearn के अंदर लीनियर मॉडल है, उसमें से लीनियर रिग्रेशन को इंपोर्ट किया. सिमिलरली sklearn हैव डिफरेंट डेटा सेट, एंड इन इन दिस पैकेज वी हैव अ डेटा सेट कॉल्ड लोड अंडरस्कोर बोस्टन. व्हाट इज दिस गाइस, यू कैन सी sklearn डॉट डेटा. You can search for this, and there are data sets available like load iris, load underscore digits, load underscore Boston. All these data sets we have inside this. Like here is description, load underscore Boston, load underscore iris, load underscore diabetes, digits, and vine and breast cancer. All these different data sets we have It is already built inside the iron. Why they have provided the desert? Basically, for any machine learning algorithm, you need certain data set. And data set should be in a proper format. Like it should be in a universal format. आप लोग एक किसी भी डेटा सेट पे आप मशीन लर्निंग कराते हैं, वो डेटा सेट पहले नॉर्मलाइज होना चाहिए, वो डेटा सेट एक प्रॉपर फॉर्मेट में होना चाहिए, देन ओनली यू कैन ट्रेन द मशीन और मशीन उसे चीजें लर्न करती है एंड मशीन उसके बाद प्रेडिक्शन कर सकती है. यानी कि आप किसी भी फॉर्मेट में डेटा फीड कर रहे हैं, डेटा आप नॉर्मलाइज नहीं है, कोई कॉलम आपका बहुत बड़ी रेंज में है, कोई कॉलम आपका बहुत छोटी रेंज में है. सो हमें एक स्टैंडर्ड डेटा सेट चाहिए होता है जब हम मशीन लर्निंग कराते हैं. सो बेसिकली इन द एसक्यूएलएन पीपल हैव ट्राइड टू बिल्ड सम स्टैंडर्ड डेटा सेट सो दैट अदर पीपल कैन प्रैक्टिस ओवर दैट. I don't think now voice is breaking. Praveen is still written, voice is not clear, and Uday is also. Guys, please confirm me. Is there any issue? Tell. Maybe you guys please check your earphones also because I'm using the same thing that I always use. Breaking, ma'am. Okay, let me check. Maybe my system is not responding properly. I'll close this program. Actually, I have started a program that takes one complete day. Now am I audible? Okay, clear now or still breaking? I think now it is clear. Right? Am I audible now? Okay, thank you all. Okay. Now come to this. We need to come to back to our topic. We wasted 5-10 minutes around, right? And I think screen is and my screen is also visible or not? Okay guys, I'm just opening my Anaconda Jupiter. Desktop screen is visible. Yes, guys, I'll repeat again. Just wait. Okay guys, we are starting from the very basic now. Okay, so first thing is predicting Boston house price with regression. As I already told you, this is a problem we are going to solve with the help of regression. So what we need to do, we need to import some libraries. Okay, so basic libraries, we already know the matplot, pandas, numpy, and now the new thing here is sklearn. So as I told you, am I audible now? Na? I just started. Okay. Thank you all. Just listen to me. Okay. I'm repeating the things again. Okay, guys. Please listen to me carefully. So we are here using the new library that is called the sklearn, and sklearn is very important library. This is this library is available in the Python for the machine learning purpose. Basically, in the Escalon, we have lots of things. One I have imported here is linear model from the Escalon, and data sets from the Escalon, and matrices from the Escalon. Okay, so simply what we are doing here, you can go to the Google and then you can search the simple things like Escalon linear model, Escalon data sets, Escalon matrices. Then you will get all the details about it. Okay, so basically I'm searching here the linear model. You can go to here and you can check here, we have linear model package available inside the Escalon, and there are the lots of things available inside this. You can read from the standard documentation. Okay, and similarly the Escalon provides the standard data sets. Why it provides the standard data sets? Actually, for the machine learning we need the standard data sets. Basically, if you don't have a standard data set, then machine cannot learn the properly. So that's why the people, some people already developed some data sets, basic data sets, and you can practice, you can start your practice from that data set only. Okay, so here we are taking one data set that is already available in the Escalon, that is the load underscore Boston. Okay. You can see here escalon.datasets, there are the lots of data sets available, and one data set is called the load underscore Boston. Okay, like CSV file or Excel file. Swati Saxena is asking a question, we can create our data set after learning. Yes, we can create, and like CSV or Excel file, yes. And we can also download the like data set for the Boston housing price also. We can download the data set from the Escalon site, or either you can directly use the function that is the defined inside the Escalon. Okay, yeah, this is the very starting practice. Okay, Ajay. So we are importing the linear model, linear regression here, and from data sets we are importing load underscore Boston. Now it's more visible. Okay, and then from the matrices, matrix is for the measurement of the performance. Escalon.matrix, we are importing mean underscore squared underscore error. Okay. Escalon is a library that is present inside the Python. Okay. Okay, Sagun, got it? So now come to the next step. Here we are just imported the important libraries only. Now come to this. What is the load underscore Boston dataset? I just want to check it out. Here, this is the data set, and you can read the description from the site, like Boston House Price data set. This data set contains 506 records, and number of attributes, 13 attributes we have, and then there is the information of attributes like crime rate, JN proportion, and these are the different parameters provided in this data set. Like we have 13 columns and 506 rows. Got it? And missing attributes, no missing attribute available, and who is created this data set. Okay, and this is a copy of the ML housing data set. You can download this data set from this link. It is available there also. So either you can download in the form of file, or you can directly import from the site. Okay, and this has been used in many machine learning papers that address regression problem. Okay, So this is the basic about the Boston data set. Now I'm coming to our program. So what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to import this load underscore Boston. Like you can see here, I have imported this load underscore Boston. Now I'm going to store this into a variable called Boston. Boston is equal to load underscore Boston. I call this function. This function will import complete data from load underscore Boston to the Boston, and you can print this Boston variable. Okay. And here you can see, like, this is the output, and this output contains different things. Like here, first, just see it as carefully, like it have a curly braces. What does mean? Curly braces started and then the curly braces closed, right? And there is the things you can see, data colon something. So this is basically a dictionary. You can see this. This is a dictionary. Data is a key, colon, then value, right? And then again, we have another key called target, then the value or at that key, okay? And then there is the another key that is called the description, feature underscore names, right? These are the keys, and this is basically a dictionary, and these are the keys and values available inside it. So we can check each and every individually. We know how to access the dictionary, right? If you want to access only the data, then you can access simply using this. Like I have data in the Boston. Boston is my dictionary. Okay, and then I just want to access the data, single quotes data. Okay, I can just print the data only. The data, this is the key, and the value inside the data is this array. Okay, or either the another way to access, here you can see this is describe Boston data set is a dictionary data set, so we can see keys of the dictionary. Or you know the function of the dictionary like boston.keys, right? So you can see all the keys all together like boston.keys. So it will show you list of all the keys, like one key is data, another is target, and third one is feature underscore names, description, and then the file name, right? And then come to the next thing. We have seen the all the keys. Now initializing the data frame. Like here is the use of the data frame pandas. We are basically converting from dictionary to data frame. Okay. Or like I'm just going to print this. And guys, please, you don't copy these things. You just type the things so that you will get the things. Like, aap log yahan par, I'm just eliminating this thing and I'm printing this one. This one will give you the list. Like here, this is the simple array and this is the converted array in the form of list kind of. So basically boston.data, you can access the dictionary data like this also, boston.data. So we are don't want an array. You can see the type of this. This is a NumPy array, right? And here you can see the type of this. This is also the NumPy array, but basically difference is ma'am, it has just a second. Dictionary, ma'am, it has 13 attributes, then it should provide 13 keys. No, no, it is not the 13 attribute means 13 columns. In the data, we have 13 columns. ओके सो वी कैन लाइक आप एक डिक्शनरी से वैल्यूज इस तरह से भी एक्सेस कर सकते हैं, डॉट की से भी कर सकते हैं एंड ब्रैकेट में की से भी कर सकते हैं, दोनों एक ही चीज होती है. गॉट इट? सो समटाइम्स आई हैव यूज्ड डॉट डेटा एंड समटाइम्स इन द ब्रैकेट सिंगल कोट्स डेटा, बोथ थिंग्स आर द सेम थिंग्स. ओके दोनों चीजें एक जैसी हैं, मैंने और कुछ भी नहीं किया, मैंने केवल बोस्टन डेटा सेट को लोड किया है, लोड करके देखा वो एक डिक्शनरी है, डिक्शनरी में से मैंने कीज चेक की हैं, कीज मेरे पास 1 2 3 4 5 कीज, आई हैव ओनली द 5 कीज एंड देन हियर यू कैन सी व्हाट इज दिस एक्चुअली. एक्चुअली डेटा में मेरा जो फीचर्स होते हैं वो है, बेसिकली डेटा हैव फीचर्स, टारगेट हैव माय आउटपुट लेबल एंड फीचर नेम्स, लाइक डेटा हैव फीचर्स एंड हियर फीचर नेम्स डिस्क्राइब द what the features inside the data and description of the total database and then the file name. Okay, you can also check it like this, like boston dot target. Okay, data humne pehle dekha. Sorry, what happened? Okay, there is two brackets. I need to write only one. Like here you can see, this is the simple list. And in the data you have seen, it is basically a group of 13 values. There are the lots of, like aap aise keh sakte ho, एक रो है जिसमें 13 कॉलम्स हैं, देन अगेन एक रो है जिसमें 13 कॉलम्स हैं. आप साइज सेव चेक कर सकते हो. अब उसमें क्या होगा, बेसिकली 13 कॉलम्स हैं एक रो में एंड टारगेट में क्या है, बेसिकली एक ही कॉलम है. Save here in the target, we have saved 506. And in the case of data, what we have saved? Boston dot data. Here you can see SAP is 506.13. Means we have 506 rows with 13 columns. And in the target, we have only one column with 506 records, 506 rows. You got it? बेसिकली एक डिक्शनरी है. स्वाति इज गेटिंग कंफ्यूज्ड व्हाट इज दिस. बेसिकली बोस्टन अंडरस्कोर लॉर्ड हैव ए डिक्शनरी एंड इन द डिक्शनरी वी हैव लॉट्स ऑफ कीज. ओके सिंपली हमने कुछ भी नहीं किया, आप लोग ज्यादा कंफ्यूज मत हो. सिंपल आपने क्या किया, यहाँ से देखो, अगेन यू विल सी इट, प्रिंट बोस्टन. बोस्टन को मैंने प्रिंट किया, इट इज समथिंग डेटा इज लुकिंग हियर. And इस डेटा को देख के मुझे क्या लग रहा है, दिस डेटा इज काइंड ऑफ डिक्शनरी. ओके देन वॉट आई हैव डन, आई हैव जस्ट चेक्ड वॉट आर द कीज इन साइड इट एंड वॉट आर द वैल्यूज. सो सिंपली आई टाइप द बोस्टन डॉट कीज, सो इट शोज मी आई हैव 5 कीज, वन इज द डेटा, अनदर इज टारगेट, देन फीचर नेम, देन डिस्क्रिप्शन एंड देन फाइल नेम. ओके If you are clear with the dictionary, then it is, I think you will get it very easily. Simple thing, I got it, you got it. Then I just want to check what is the value inside this key, like this data key have what values. So I have just printed Boston oblique Boston data. Data key mein kya values hai, wo maine print kiya. Simply maine dekha ek array aaya. I got an array. Now I just want to check the shape of the array. What is the shape of this array? Shape of this array, I have checked, it shows me it have 506 rows and 13 columns. Just got it? And then I checked the shape of target key. So it have 506 columns. Okay, guys, simply I just checked, and then again I'll check print Boston dot feature underscore names. Okay, Boston dot feature underscore names. I just checked the feature names. So it shows me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. These are the 13 features you can see. So you can assume this like these are the 13 columns, heading of the columns, and the columns data inside the data key. Okay, and this one is the target. Okay, here you can see this thing inside this print Boston dot description. Okay, in the description it shows you like what is the basically Boston data set. Boston data set is Boston housing price data set. This data set characteristics is number of instances means number of rows 506, number of attributes means number of columns 13. Okay, and the description of these columns are these. So ye basically kya aapka feature names. And missing values, there is no missing values. This data set was taken from this standard lab, which is maintained at this university. Okay, so this is the description of this data set. And then the last point is, last key is file name. So you can check the file name also, print Boston dot file name. And this is the file name actually created. You can check in your system. It will give you some path. Basically, जैसे ही आप इसको load करते हैं, एक Boston underscore house underscore prices dot csv in your current folder एक file बन जाती है. और या इधर आपको एक sklearn का path देगा कि यहाँ पर जाके data के अंदर ये एक आपके system में file बन गई. Got it? Now I'm coming to your question. This is all about the data set, what we have in the data set. Swati's, ma'am, your point are clear to me. And then Rusikesh is asking how to read this data set. I just told you, Rusikesh. I think now it is clear to you. Just import dot data set and then the this function. How to read? Read for the reading purpose. First, you need to import this, import load underscore Boston, and then use this function load underscore Boston store in a variable. Simply call this function. And I'm coming to the next question I got from Sagar. Please correct me. Boston is a dictionary. Data target features are arrays. Yes, Sagar, it is correct. Boston is a dictionary, and then inside the dictionary we have keys, data target, feature name, and these keys have some arrays. Arrays of values, some values array. Got it? And Rusikesh, can we import this data set without using sklearn? Yes, you can use, like you can simply download this data set. It is, I think, available over the GitHub. Simply Boston, just search out Boston load underscore CSV file, and you can download, and then simply you can read, like you know how to read the file using the pandas. And then simply we can perform the further operations. Okay. And Ganesh is asking a question. Only we are using dictionaries XN in Boston. No, it is not like that. This data set is in form of dictionary. So we are reading this data set. Pushpendra is asking description ke upar maine kya likha hai? Features. Feature underscore names, Boston dot feature underscore names. I just checked each and every key. Like I just checked the Boston dot keys. Then there are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 keys. I just checked the each and every key. Each key, what is having? Simply, I just checked Boston dot data, Boston dot target, Boston dot feature underscore names, Boston dot description, Boston dot file. Okay. Sagar is asking, but type Boston is not giving dictionary. You can see basically this Boston is, you can look like this, you can see the basically, and I think it would give, maybe there is some, I'll check it. I never check the type, I'll just check it, wait. Print. Yeah, it is the Eskill and Bunch dictionary. Basically, it is a kind of data set they have defined. Because we are reading directly from the Eskill, and so it is a bunch file kind of. But it, you can see this from the structure. It is basically a dictionary. Maybe they have defined something utils.bunch. You can search out what is this. Okay, Sagar. But by viewing this data, you can estimate, you can simply check dot keys function is working here. It is a dictionary, it's showing the keys, values, and these are the things. Basically, dictionary is a data type of Python, and we are here working in the Boston's some data type. So it is a kind of class that is defined inside the Escalar. But the main base data type is dictionary. Okay, Sagar, clear it. And okay, Daniel is searched out over the Google. He's written something. I'm just reading. Just wait. And return. Data bunch dictionary like object that. Dictionary like object. Actually, this data bunch, he searched this sklearn util bunch. You can also search over the Google. And this will give you some outputs like this. V, and this is kind of dictionary. Bunch is container object exposing keys as attribute R. I'm not getting the things. Basically, you can say data bunch is also a dictionary. Okay. It follows all the concepts of dictionary. Now come to this. Okay. Till now, we have just checked the each and every key. Okay. Now what we will do next, we have data. Now we'll going to apply the machine learning. So first what we need to do, we need to divide this data into two part. One is the training part and another one is testing part. Okay. And one more thing, what we need to do, like, when you want to divide the data into the test and training, so what you need to do, you need to make data in the form of X or Y. Here we are like we are following an equation of a line. So basically what we need two things. One is the X and another one is Y, right? We need X or Y. So what will be the X here and what will be the Y here? Basically, X is our data and Y is our target. Okay. And we need to combine these two things together, x and y. Like आप लोग एक CSV फाइल बनाते हो. CSV फाइल में क्या होता है, पहले सारे फीचर होते हैं, फिर उनका आउटपुट होता है. हमारे पास सेपरेट सेपरेट कीज में है, हम उसको एक जगह करेंगे पहले, ठीक है. सो बेसिकली हम लोग यहाँ पे क्या कर रहे हैं, लाइक एडिंग टारगेट वेरिएबल टू द डेटा सेट. हमारी डिक्शनरी में हमने एक डिक्शनरी है जिसमें सारे डेटा है हमारे पास, ठीक है. अब हम लोग क्या कर रहे हैं, इसको डेटा फ्रेम में, सबसे पहले हम डिक्शनरी को हटा के डेटा फ्रेम बना रहे हैं. अब डेटा फ्रेम बना लेते हो थोड़ा सा इजी रहता है. लाइक बोस्टन डॉट डेटा डॉट सेप आई हैव ऑलरेडी चेक्ड, आई डोंट नीड टू चेक इट आउट अगेन. एंड बोस्टन डॉट डेटा, आई एम कन्वर्टिंग बोस्टन डॉट डेटा टू टू डेटा फ्रेम. बेसिकली मैं एक पर्टिकुलर की को ले रही हूँ, डेटा की को, एंड उस डेटा की के डेटा को मैं डेटा फ्रेम में कन्वर्ट कर रही हूँ, बिकॉज मैं डेटा फ्रेम में इजिली ऑपरेशन कर पाऊंगी, ठीक है. सो आई इम्पोर्टेंट द पांडास, सो पी डी डॉट डेटा फ्रेम बोस्टन डॉट डेटा आई पास्ट इन टू द बॉस, ओके. एंड सिंपली आई कैन रीड इट, बॉस डॉट हैड टू सिंपल रूल्स. ये एक्चुअली मुझे लेबल डेटा दिखेगा, एरे में मुझे चीजें समझ नहीं आ रही थी, दैट्स व्हाई आई हैव कन्वर्टेड इट टू द डेटा फ्रेम, ओके. टू रोज एंड 13 कॉलम्स, ओके गाइस, क्लियर टिल नाउ. सो सिंपली आई एम कन्वर्टिंग दिस बोस्टन डॉट डेटा टू द डेटा फ्रेम. नाउ आर माई डेटा इन इन साइड द बॉस, एंड बॉस हैव शेप ऑफ द बॉस basically 506, 506, 13. simply I have data. now I just want to combine the data. this is the my x only. now I just want to add y also here. so I just want to add one more column. or here I just want to give the title name as my feature names. right? I have my feature names inside the boston dot feature underscore names that I want to give into the title. okay? so simply what I will do, boston dot feature underscore name I already know, boss dot columns, this is the columns in the data frame. what have the columns, columns have header. so boss dot columns equals to boston dot feature underscore names. so here I have put it the boss dot columns this, and now simply I can print the boss dot head, okay. you can see now what is happening, I have column names also. I'll just print two so that upper code also will show you, okay. simple, I have taken boston dot data to the data frame that is the now called boss, okay. and then check the shape, and boston dot features name I already know, boss dot columns is equal to boston dot feature names. so in the heading of the boss it will put the feature names. simply I'm decorating my data actually, okay. now I just want to add here one more column that is called the price column, okay. one more column how to add in the data frame. so in the data frame if you want to add more column, then what you need to write, like boss, and I just want to add the price column, okay, equals to what is here, boston dot target, right. and you can simply print boss dot head 2. here now you can see that one more extra column is added, that is called the price. Mohit is asking, ma'am, what is the boss dot head? actually what is inside the boss, inside the boss I have put it the boston dot data. एक डेटा फ्रेम बनाया मैंने बॉस, जिसके अंदर बोस्टन डॉट डेटा का जो भी डेटा था वो सारा बॉस के अंदर चला गया एज ए डेटा फ्रेम. यू कैन सी दिस कमांड. ओके एंड देन हेड मतलब मैं उसको प्रिंट करके देख रही हूँ डेटा फ्रेम में, आपने पढ़ाई था. शेप मैं उसके प्रिंट करके देख रही हूँ, उसके कॉलम्स में डाल रही हूँ, राइट. अब उसमें मैं एक नया कॉलम ऐड कर रही हूँ, दैट इज कॉल्ड द बॉस प्राइस इज इक्वल टू बोस्टन डॉट टारगेट. ऑल आर गाइज विथ मी, आर यू फॉलोइंग ऑल द थिंग्स? ओके ओके सो सिंपली आई हैव एडेड वन मोर कॉलम दैट इज कॉल्ड द प्राइस. नाउ आई हैव कंप्लीट डेटा इनसाइड द बॉस. आई नीड टू डिवाइड दिस डेटा इनटू टू पार्ट, वन इज द ट्रेनिंग पार्ट, अनदर वन इज द टेस्टिंग पार्ट. Price value, I put it from the boston.target. boston.target have one column that is the final output. So isko maine name de diya price aur isko maine dal diya boston underscore price is equal to boston.target. agar aapko ek extra column add karna hota hai to is tarah se add hota hai equals to jo aap dalte wo uski value mein chala jata hai. okay Rusikesh. Now I need to divide this data into two parts. So for the data dividation, I need to import some package from the sklearn. sklearn से data set तो हमने ले लिया था, but अब हमें क्या करना है? Data set के अलावा data को divide करने के लिए वहाँ पे function available होता है, वो हमें लेना होता है. Actually इस पूरे code में sklearn का बहुत बड़ा role होता है. sklearn आपको जब थोड़ा समझ आने लग जाता है उसके बाद आप मशीन लर्निंग के एल्गोरिथम्स बहुत इजीली इंप्लीमेंट कर लेते हैं. आई गॉट इट, गॉट अ क्वेश्चन. अभी कृष्णा वेट, हम एक्स्ट्रा रो ऐड नहीं करेंगे. अभी रो हम ऐड कर सकते हैं. नाउ अब हमें इसको एक्स और वाई के फॉर्मेट में डालना है. मैंने जैसे पहले आपको बताया एक एक्स होता है एक वाई होता है, तो सिंपली आपको दो पार्ट में डिवाइड करना है. तो आप वाई किसको लोगे? वाई इज इक्वल टू बॉस. आप कॉलम नहीं ऐड करें तो भी कोई नीड नहीं है, बस मैं सिंपली इसलिए बताया मैंने कि कैसे कई बार आपको नीड पड़ जाती है. जो प्राइस के अंदर है उसको मैं वाई में डाल रही हूँ, ठीक है, बिकॉज ये मेरा टारगेट है. सिंपली ये मेरा एक डेटा फ्रेम है, ठीक है. वाई इज इक्वल टू बॉस प्राइस मैंने डाल दिया. नाउ व्हाट आई विल डू हियर, एक्स इज इक्वल टू बॉस डॉट ड्रॉप. मेरे को एक पर्टिकुलर कॉलम ड्रॉप करना है, कौन सा? प्राइस का. मैंने केवल ड्रॉप और ये इसलिए दिखाया आपको, यहाँ पे आप एक नई फंक्शनलिटी लर्न कर लें, बाकी मैं इसको डायरेक्ट भी कर सकती थी. एक्स इज इक्वल टू वन, यानी मुझे ये एक कंप्लीट कॉलम ऐड डिलीट करना है, इसकी सारी रोज प्राइस कॉलम की. ओके एंड सिंपली आई विल प्रिंट व्हाट हैपेंड. प्रिंट x dot head to, एंड ये जब अब सारी चीजें मेरी डेटा फ्रेम में है, पहले मेरी सारी चीजें डेटा फ्रेम में नहीं थी इसलिए मैंने कुछ एक्सरसाइज की यहाँ पे. y dot head, okay, x dot head and y dot head to. okay now you can see the output. So simply, this is my x, it have, and this is my y. Okay. Okay guys, now I need to divide this data into the two parts. One is the x and another one is the y. Split the data x train and y train, x test and y train test. Basically ye important hota hai. Aap yahan pe kya karenge, aapke paas do cheeze hai, ek aapke paas x hai, sorry, and ek aapke paas y hai. Ab aapko dono ko divide karna hai, theek hai, x train and x test. Okay, similarly y train or y test. इसका मीनिंग क्या होता है कि जैसे आपके पास 506 रोज हैं, 506 में से आप 506 ही तो रोज आपके पास x में, 506 रोज ही y में है. अब आप 506 रोज में से 75% रोज टेस्ट के लिए ले रहे हैं, उसके करस्पॉन्डिंग y भी आपको चाहिए, ठीक है, ट्रेनिंग के लिए ले रहे हैं, उसके करस्पॉन्डिंग आपको y भी चाहिए, राइट. सिमिलरली आप रिमेनिंग 30% डेटा टेस्टिंग के लिए ले रहे हैं, तो x का जो टेस्ट होगा उसके करस्पॉन्डिंग y टेस्ट होना चाहिए. You are getting my point? Like मैं अभी divide करके दिखाती हूँ, मैं यहाँ से function ले लेती हूँ. SKLearn have a library that is called the model underscore selection. So we can import sklearn.model_selection and there is a function called train_test_split. Okay. So this is the simple sklearn.model_selection.train_test. What we are writing inside it, similarly x and then the y, and then we need to provide the test size. So test underscore size is equal to 0.33. It means test size would be 33% and remaining will be go inside the train. Okay, and here we have taken one thing is random state is equal to any number. You can take random state is equal to any number. It means basically you are doing this activity one time and then again after some time you just want to do the same activity again. So, आप अगर रैंडम स्टेट इज इक्वल टू कोई नंबर नहीं लेते हैं तो आप नेक्स्ट टाइम जब करेंगे तो टेस्ट ट्रेन में दूसरा डेटा जाएगा, इस बार दूसरा जाएगा. एंड सिमिलरली हमें क्या चाहिए होता है, वी नीड कंसिस्टेंसी. दैट्स व्हाई वी आर कीपिंग दिस रैंडम स्टेट इज इक्वल टू 5. इट मीन्स फर्स्ट टाइम इट इज हैविंग द 400 रिकॉर्ड्स, इन द सेकेंड टाइम ऑल्सो इट विल कीप द सेम 400 रिकॉर्ड्स फॉर द ट्रेनिंग एंड द रिमेनिंग फॉर द टेस्टिंग. इट विल नॉट चेंज द वैल्यूज. And if you are not writing this, it means randomly it will take the 400 record first time, and second time when it is taking the 400 for the training, it will can take the another records. Got it? So simply sklearn.model_selection.train_test_split x comma y and then the test size and then random state, and then how it will store in the four variables corresponding to this, like first x train and then x test, then y, so y train and y test. Order should be same, always you should keep the order like this, like first variable, then first variable train and test, then second variable train and test. Data will go like this only. Order always you should follow. Got it, Sagar, Rushikesh, Ganesh, Sudhanshu. Swati is written, please repeat again. And Krishna is also want again. Just wait. Yeah, this is the simple taste and train split. Just remove it. Random state, I'm removing it right now. Okay. Control Z. Oh, sorry. Okay, I'm just running this only. Now you can get, we have a function called train underscore taste underscore split inside the sklearn. And we need to divide data into the two parts. Like one is the training part and another one is the testing part. So X should be divided into two parts, like train and test. And similarly, Y should be divided into the two parts, train and test. So here we have written X comma Y and then the test size. This is the syntax of train underscore test underscore split function. So it will divide the data into the four part and the order should be like first it will store X train, X test, then Y train, Y test. Okay, and 33% data will go inside the test and 67% data will go inside the train state. And next thing is I'm putting the random variable. Random state means what is the syntax error here? Random state means one time I have run this code without the random state. I just run this code. Like you can check the values of X train